call Zambia a landlocked country. But over the years, that narrative has changed to Zambia being a land-linked country. This is because the country is surrounded by a number of countries without access to the coast. This has forced the country to be connected by road and air to its neighbors who have access to ports and seas. Fondly called the real Africa, Zambia is endowed with diversity. Wildlife is all over and the country is blessed with many minerals. The country is the second largest producer of copper in Africa and the third largest producer in the world. Mineral dependency has been there for over half a century. Like many other third world countries, Zambia has for years been facing challenges with proper waste management strategies, as well as protecting the environment from pollution and prevention of communicable diseases that are brought due to poor public health services. It is behind this background that Nvumabaranda Public Health Services, a private company specializing in public health services in the mineral-rich Copperbelt and Northwestern provinces, is offering solutions to these challenges. Company Managing Director Kennedy Nduna shares how this company came about and what its core business is.
It's a company that was founded in 2005. Basically, what we do in this company, there are three components that we do. We do disease prevention, then we also manage hazardous waste. Under managing of hazardous waste, that includes storage, importation, and recycling of the same hazardous waste. The third part is the pest control. Under pest control, we do rodent control, pests and malaria, that is mosquito control.
Nvumabaranda is currently operating in 5 offices in Ndola, Solwezi, Bumwana, Kalumbira and Lusaka, where it is specialized in pest, rodent and mosquito control, general public health services and waste recycling. In Ndola, among other services being offered, is rodent control and medical waste management to designated incinerators. And in Solwezi district, the firm is operating at the first Quantum Run consumption mine, dealing with disposal of hazardous waste. The site coordinator now explains.
This is a hazardous waste facility for treatment and storage. And you can see there's some empty chemical bags there in plastics that are usually sorted out and taken to a recycling facility. And in that shed, we have various chemicals and items which range from lead crucibles, grease, and used oil. So all these things are brought from different parts of different sites of the mine, and then they're brought here to be sorted out and in readiness for shipment. You know, we're trying to go towards a green environment and we want to promote sustainability. So with that effect, as Nvumabaranda Public Health Services, we try to ensure that most of our activities are within the lines and stipulations of the Environmental Management Agency.
At the Rumwana site in the newly created Kalumbira district, Nvumabaranda staffer explains how the waste collected is sorted and disposed of.
We've installed the bins across the site, inside the mine and outside. White labeled bins which we use to collect waste from. And we do the collection of waste 3 times in a week for the areas which has less generative areas to collect 3 times in a week. And for high generating areas, we do collect almost every day. And then after the collections inside the mine and outside, we bring our waste here at the landfill. That's where we do our sorting from. As you can see, we do the sorting. We collect waste like plastic bottles, plastic, empty bags, containers, filters, and rubber. That's the waste we collect here.
We do that in order to reduce the amount of waste being buried at the dump site, hence creating more space and longer lifespan for the landfills. And then from BME, we also collect waste emulsion and we take it for recycling and disposal to South Africa. We also collect IBCs, empty IBCs, which are refilled by BME in South Africa also.
Nvumabaranda Public Health Services is also involved in providing shelter for workers in Karumbira district by managing a campsite, rooms and other facilities. At the heart of its operations, Nvumabaranda Public Health Services Logistics Department operates vehicles which carry materials for making explosives from Kansanshi to Karumbira mines in the northwestern province. This is critical for the sustenance of the two mines. The company does not want to be left behind with trains.
We are here in Solwezi. We have this agro shop that we run and the auto shop as well. So when we talk about the agro shop, here you find products like roach wipe because we also specialize in pest control. So we encourage farmers to come here if they've got a problem with armyworms which are attacking their fields, which are attacking their crops. This is the right place to come to buy the products so that you get rid of those worms and so that you can have a good harvest. And then talking of the auto shop, well, our auto shop is well equipped. We have everything that you need. You have a breakdown, just come to Vuma Auto Shop. You find everything that you're looking for.
They are running agro and auto shops and looking into setting up recycling centers as well as manufacture chemicals in the near future to ensure that Zambia's environment is safeguarded. This diversification is not a far-fetched dream, as company general manager explains.
Hydrocarbons, when you bury them, they are going to affect the environment, and that's going to degrade our environment, which is going to disturb even for the future, like the future generations to come. So instead of us burying or just throwing it away anyhow, it's better we recycle it. Right now, there are a lot of waste that we can recycle. Plastics can be recycled because those, they won't decompose in this period of time. They take time. Yes. So management of waste, first of all, I think from the generation points, if we can learn to start separating plastic from paper and bottles, if we can manage to separate them, then that will really help us. And like where we just disposing, like we are doing in Lumwana, currently we are separating. There are bins like for each and every type of waste that you're disposing of. So if that system can be adopted even somewhere else, I think it's really going to help Zambia. We won't have this challenge that we have at the moment where landfills are filled with this domestic waste that is a composition of, it's a plastic paper. Yeah, so that I think is going to reduce, and we are going to save our environment from degrading it. And
recently, the company welcomed a number of visitors from East Africa who were in the country to appreciate the role the company is playing in ensuring environmental sustainability. These Kenyans were impressed with what they saw.
I work as a quality advisor. I work with healthcare facilities, so majorly concentrating a lot around clinical waste. And just generally as a country, we have a menace of waste management, managing domestic waste and other waste. So really, it's an opportunity to come and learn how you do it here.
I'm also in healthcare management, which is where we met Duna when we were doing the managing healthcare businesses course. And when he did his presentation, we all took interest because we were quite impressed, because it's a common thing we have as well in Kenya. And we thought it would be a good idea to just come down and see exactly how it runs, how, you know, from the inception to the finish, how it's managed, and we'll see how we can apply if need be, or where we can, our input as well.
We were impressed by his very interest, especially in the waste management. because nobody thought about waste can give you money, even employment. And we're impressed even when we are here to see when some of the engineers, they're still in that sector of waste management or whatever, and they can get something. Mine, I'm saying, we're happy to see even our fellow African people coming up with a company, you know, bringing something new to help our own people and even to get, to solve our problem. I think that is a credit to that.
Conserve the environment, especially the oak forest. We've seen a lot of indigenous trees. Most part of Kenya, the trees that we've planted, meaning we destroyed the indigenous trees, and we are now trying to plant again. So this trip has really been informative, and I'm happy that I came.
I run a company called Profit, where we help our clients to manage and prevent chronic diseases using physical exercise. So being in the same class as Luna and seeing his presentation in terms of what he's doing is going beyond what people think about healthcare. When you mention healthcare, you only think about someone who's sick and medicine. But him going beyond and preventing the environment to help sustain everybody's health. So it's about preventing. So coming here has really been an informative trip whereby now we can experience the real change that he is doing with his team. So like all my colleagues have said, you guys have preserved the greener pasture and trees, which is very hard. In Kenya we miss this environment, so it's a plus when you can go back, you can be able to let our people know that it can be done. You can cut down and then you can plant again.
At a time when the issue of pollution is getting prominence worldwide, the job Nvumabaranda is doing is commendable. It is hoped that many more corporate entities will be more responsible to the environment, as Nvumabaranda has shown.